So you said this is what they use in the auto industry most often?
Yes. So this is the Gen 3. They're actually going to Gen 4. I'm actually the Qualcomm partner. I'm a Red Hat partner. I deal with all the small guys. So we're actually now going towards their Gen 4 core boards.
Okay.
You are.
But out of the box, you know, we can be on anything. We have a professional services that actually, if you have a board that you really like, we're not out of the box. We could do it, port it to it, but there's certain technologies that are already done out of the box. The integration's already done.
Right, this is like similar to the kind of Tesla.
Yes. Well, Tesla uses Qt to.
Oh, they do?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
So there you go.
Making some connections.
Yeah. So most of your in-vehicle, entertainment and the experience, outside of the cluster two, both on Qt.
Okay.
So and then we also, that's why we're also talking about being on Android Auto.
I don't know what's on this.
A lot of people want to use Android Auto. It's okay. They can have a hybrid with Qt running Android Auto. And leveraging all the apps and stuff like that for the entertainment.
And then over there, that's a medical field.
So we're across 70 industries, 70.
Okay.
We have some strategic ones where we go deep, especially the regulated industries. So aerospace, automotive, medical. I'm actually also not only the product manager. I started with the company as the medical product manager, so I still work in the medical industry as well. So a lot of the regulated industries, and then industrial IoT, consumer IoT, a little deeper, in telecom. We're in I'm working with NVIDIA in the media, entertainment, and broadcast kind of industry, so we're starting to make roads into there too.
Okay.
So
like there's the Tesla example that we gave. What's some other really common popular technologies that people are using Qt in the morning?
Yeah, well, it's shouldn't be talking about the OS. There's definitely a popular OS that's being used, but the Qualcomm is the board that's pretty much prevalent in auto.
Okay.
And then there's a real-time operating system, but again, with Red Hat and Drivo's team, we're starting to work with them and connect them through our automotive experience. So we're working with them pretty closely with that.
Awesome.
So just more options, there's definitely market leaders. I think what's happening now is that people are looking outside of the standard, so there's a lot of expanding. So it's all based on the OEM.
So for Qt, you guys make the money as a business, Tesla and all these other OEMs reach out to you guys to develop custom.
So our business is subscription licensing of the technology and licensing the QA tools and everything. So that's 80% of our business, and then the other 20% we do have professional services. We have Qt engineers to actually help.
And so for the open source side of it, ADB Plasma and all, that's just what's the separation?
Separation, it's mostly your support. So there's a certain amount of support for obviously the OS. But then when you really get into especially some of the regulated industries and there is some functional safety stuff, there's some tool sets that aren't available in open source that are available commercially. So it's a different strategy for both of the products. So it just depends, on does the company want to manage the compliance with the open source and all of their requirements?
Yeah.
Or do they just want to buy commercial and just worry about all that.
Awesome.
What was your name?
Roger.
Nice to meet you.